The toll on hospitals already being felt across this country. Word that some ICUs are near capacity as the number of cases soars. And tonight, the doctors who say they do not have what they need. Here's ABC's chief national correspondent, Matt Gutman.
Tonight, one of the biggest expansions in hospital space in American history. From coast to coast, temporary hospitals being built at breakneck speed. This field unit for coronavirus patients under construction on a soccer field outside Seattle. And this as emergency room officials fear being overrun when the virus peaks.
We have patients who we suspect highly have COVID, but have not been, the testing is not completed because the testing is taking so substantially long. Our ICUs are already at capacity before this pandemic began, and now we're pushing them over.
While thousands are lining up at drive-through testing sites like these in Texas and Georgia, so many seeking tests are unable to get them.
I was sitting on the couch, and my wife was in the kitchen, and I almost passed out, just out of the blue.
39-year-old Sacramento resident Justin Willite has been to the emergency room twice in the last 8 days. Doctors tell him they are 100% certain he has the virus, but they told him the tests are only for those in dire need.
It was more frustrating for my wife because my wife wanted more definitive answers.
With officials in Los Angeles setting up this RV park as a possible quarantine site, doctors across the country now pleading with people to stay home. This physician in Atlanta holding up a sign saying, "I stayed at work for you, you stay home for us." Especially since some of those doctors on the front lines are especially vulnerable too.
I can't walk away from this pandemic while I'm needed. But that said, I have at least a tenfold higher mortality rate.
Some hospitals reporting a short supply of ventilators. Doctors in other countries have rigged them so patients could share them, but haven't taken that measure yet. That is now being discussed as a last resort among some health officials.
We're exploring how to make that work, and that creativity is absolutely essential.
Yeah, we need creativity, but we also need them to be extraordinarily careful. And I know they're considering everything. Sharing those ventilators, a worst case scenario, because there are risks with that too.
There are, David, and that's because it's never before been tried on humans. Now, they can split those ventilators, but it still requires skilled technicians to monitor the patients. There's also a concern that these patients are breathing the same air and could transmit diseases, and this is why doctors keep telling us to flatten the curve so hospitals don't have to get into these situations where they use these unprecedented measures. David.
Matt Gutman tonight. Thank you, Matt.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.